They're about to start coaching in there. All you're going to hear is me in the background. Hey guys, welcome to my vlog. Miami. South Beach, bringing the heat. Ready, bitches. What's happening, y'all? Daily P episode 3, South Florida vlog. Been excited to get the big man over here and kind of show my lifestyle out here. It's a good life, got the sun, but it is a grind life too, so I'm looking forward to taking you through my routine here. I'm gonna get on the bag, do some striking work here now, and then we're gonna do some strength conditioning with Brandon Gallagher later on. So excited to introduce you to Brandon, absolute legend, great guy, amazing coach, and show you the team here in Killcliff, a team of absolute legends, great people, great fighters. It's an absolute privilege to be here. Honestly, I'm so grateful. So I'm excited to show everybody what my kind of lifestyle is like here in South Florida. And yeah, this is Daily P episode 3, South Florida edition. Let's go.
Every single challenge in here, fights are easy, right? And we talk about it, like, as a mental point, I go back to the UK, I go and train, and then that's the one thing that I can't do, is give myself the affirmations when I come in here to say I've been tested. Here, fighting's fucking easy to this year.
That's why we're here to be the best.
Coming here most days, you get beat up.
I know.
Most days.
Yeah. Take it easier, you know, you're tired, and then some guy's like, we go next, and we're like, oh, okay, I guess we're going next.
Together we make it work, you know?
Yeah.
That's it. If you don't have sparring partners, then at one moment you get exposed, that's just the way it is.
That's just how it is.
Or you feel that you're the best, and then you go to another gym, you're like, holy shit, no, I'm not really, I need to work on this shit.
So no matter how fit you are, if you hit fight or flight, where it's a matter of survival, your shit's gonna go out the fucking window, right? Yeah. Now, that only happens when you second guess your ability.
Yeah.
The only time you're ever gonna second guess your ability is when you get in, the cage door shuts, and you haven't had the test outside.
Yeah,
right? Yeah. So it's like, this is the longest time since COVID. I've spent 6 months here now. So I know that this is right.
Yeah.
Everything else is what it is. You know what I mean?
See the steps, it's closing your distance and it's taking longer to get to my head.
Yeah.
Throw it more straight. Like almost the same line as the tee. The knee just comes
straight.
Sometimes guys will block it, but it just takes one. It just takes one for that to just sink right around the back of the ear. And my coach at home, Shanda, would say, like, it's like a ball and chain.
Yeah.
You know, at the very end point is where it's gonna be sore. If I hit at the middle, it's not gonna hurt.
Yeah.
You know?
It's but more like a shin and can't even get through if the hand is dead.
It's like your foot is wrapping around the side of his head. Like, this basically how I won my last fight.
But definitely the best SI I've ever had, by a landslide, and it just so happens to be in the premises of the gym. Shout out to Ray, my guy, the craic cafe, the best, honestly, we'd be eating this shit every day. I could eat two of these every day, no problem at all.
We're gonna do a little contest where everybody's gonna get an ounce of raw liver, and the first one to finish wins Liver King's bars.
Last one to finish, bro. I'm just gonna be over here like.
Yeah, first one to finish wins
licking
all this.
His fingers.
So, I'm a little bloodied up right now. I got a bad gag reflex. Taste it. So, no.
Yeah, once you're done divvying it out, maybe.
Yeah, make sure you get him off the money to Brian. He's gonna definitely do something.
He knows. I have the worst gag reflex ever, dude, in anybody. Well,
there will be no swallowing, you sissies. You have to chew it, okay? No swallowing.
How many chews?
I chew and savor it.
Yeah. Like the chewing? Like a tequila shot.
At least three chews?
No, that's too bad.
Ten chews.
I did it. I say whoever chews the longest.
Chew it up, swallow, and if you throw up after, you lose.
Right. What if I go like this, but I don't throw up?
Yeah, you can hands up. Everybody,
you can
say, go.
Ah.
I thought I tied on. Were you looking? Were you watching?
I didn't even finish mine.
It's really good.
We need an instant replay, but he was kind of watching on and Christos throw up, so.
You
didn't put this in your mouth, did you?
Hey, Paul, here, I got one for you, dude. I got one for you, dude. Come on, bro.
Like the smell of a zoo.
It felt like it was like crunchy. Different breed. God damn. Yeah.
No, I'm savoring it.
He's savoring it. He just likes it.
How does he win?
Come on, Chris.
I'm gonna man the fuck up.
Yeah. Guys, let's go, Chris. Let's go, Chris.
Let's go. Let's go. That's my boy.
It's such a violent. It's such a violent gag.
He just like likes Chris.
Oh, man, get that.
Folks, I'm buzzing to announce that Carl Robert has now joined the team as a premium full-time sponsor. Carl Robert Accident Repair specialise in fault and non-fault insurance claims. They deal with both parties in the event of an accident with no cost and provide a hassle-free service. Check them out on IG. Welcome to the team, Carl Robert. I'm absolutely buzzing. Thank you so much. Support me all the way to the top. I appreciate it. Let's go, guys.
Are they like?
They're electric.
They're electric.
Yeah.
Got a little month.
So you got your rear brake, front brake, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, and then this is throttle.
Yep, yeah. That's already on.
Yeah, sure. Like
all right, let's go. Let's go have some fun.
Dude, it's probably the most like straight face,
yeah.
Emotionless.
He's not even going fast. He's just like,
is he having a good time?
He's thinking about killing somebody.
man. It's a good time. Get on this bad boy.
Yeah.
Let's go, buddy.
Just like a normal bike.
Yeah. Wait. Actually, I got this thing up because.
Wish me luck.
You got it. Go have some fun. Take a couple laps, man.
If I die, I die.
Open that bad boy up.
Look at the arch.
You do the plus. Plus it up to four. Hit the plus.
Fucking yow! Man, fucking yow!
Scared me right there.
fun, right?
It's pretty fucking cool.
With the Birkins? With the Birkinstocks?
Yeah.
This kid just doesn't care out
the
here.
Trip.
Shirtless Birkinstocks on a motorized bike?
No fuck.
He doesn't give a fuck today. I'm going to
Miami. Welcome to Miami. So, what's it been like training in Killcliff, like these facilities?
Oh, sick. Absolutely sick, bro. Life's good here, you know? Life's good, but people are like, oh, you know, you're living the dream, you're living the life, you've some life and all. But it's like, yes, I do, and I've worked unbelievably hard to get here, but it's unbelievably hard even being here, you know, because you're pushing yourself to the limit. Like, you don't just get here on accident, and you don't stay here and improve on accident. You have to dedicate your entire life, your entire being, and that's what I'm continuing to do. I'm here to get better, you know, I'm here to mix it up with some of the best coaches and fighters in the world, and that's what you got to do to reach the top. It's that simple. So yeah, so I first came to America like 7 years ago now, which makes me feel old as shit, but I was 19 when I first came out here and done my first summer and met the lads, and we've been best friends ever since. We see each other like 3, 4, 5 times per year. So some of them are living in New York now, so they came down from New York to Miami for the weekend, so we got to spend a few days together. That was fucking sick, bro. Jet skiing was fire. Here I am in the place where I come let go. In Miami, the base and the sunset low. Every day like a Mardi Gras. Everybody party all day. No work, all play, okay? So we sip a little something, lay the rest is spill. Me and Charlie at the bar running up a high bill. Funny, because I kind of was like, yes, I was getting the adrenaline going fast and all that, but I was kind of just like, at times, just driving around the surrounding area, like looking at all the amazing houses, apartment blocks, and it kind of just got me thinking, like, just deeply about my life, and just got me feeling super grateful, like, because not everyone gets to do these sorts of things and experience that and travel around the world doing what they love. So I do continue to be grateful for it, because yeah, gratitude's everything at the end of the day. Grateful, you have to keep reminding yourself, because your mind will play tricks on you. It'll play tricks on you and tell you that you don't have enough, or that you're not enough, but you are, trust me in that. And we all need to just take multiple times throughout the day to just give thanks and be grateful for what we have, because we live in the best time ever to be alive. You're about to fall. We live in the best time ever to be alive, and that's just facts. So a bit of gratitude is in order for sure, you know. Shut up. Trying to do a vlog here. So most people are going to be wondering, what the fuck is going on, and why are you not signed to the UFC yet? There's Twitter things going mad all the time, messages all the time. What's going on? Why is Paul Hughes not signed to the UFC yet? And that's the question that everybody wants the answer to. And that's what the answer I want as well. But things have been positive, I'll say that. Things have been very positive with the UFC. Of course, we've been in contact a lot. They like me. I'll say no more than that. They like me. And we've almost got there. I don't like to give too much away for multiple reasons. I like to keep my private life private. Some things is nobody's business, but I'll have some good stories whenever I get signed that I can just release and tell everyone. That'll be interesting. So I'm looking forward to that. Right now, of course, heads down, grinding my ass off every day like I do. And trust me, when that time comes, I'm gonna explode onto the scene. Everyone knows how good I am, you know. I am the biggest prospect in the world outside of the UFC, and in my opinion, well, I'm a fucking superstar. I know that, and everyone's about to see that. And I'm gonna come in hot into the UFC, and I will be incredibly active early. Like, something that's been very frustrating is my activity levels the last year or 2 years, because things are different, you know. When there's champ, there's unification bouts, there's okay, you can't fight this date, that date, niggles, injuries, all these things. So I know when I signed to the UFC, it's like bang, bang, bang. I'm ready to go at featherweight, I'm ready to go at lightweight. Like, I'm ready to fight my ass off whenever I get in there and blow up and become that superstar that I already know that I am. But I want to finally show the rest of the world who I am, and I'm fucking confident. I'm confident. So I'm looking forward to y'all to see that. Very, very much looking forward to it.
That's January 1st.
First world title fight.
Let's go.
So my time is just the nice slogan. So that's the original.
Or the fee for me signing this, by the way.
Never. Never it is.
$10. $150.
$5.
How about $50?
Boom.
Big news.
Big news.
First smell of a salt bike in the air.
I'll be alright. No way. I live here.
Just have air. That oxygen depth with the nasal load, it's a zone where you have to, there's just a maintenance where you can't really go over it.
Yeah.
Otherwise you're gonna have to go. So it's good to understand that.
It's good.
Pace, exactly what you're talking about. This is why he's the fucking man. Knows the ins and outs. That was all nasal. So the kind of secret weapon of this, what you think is the easy bit is the ball. It is easier than a bag, I guess, but the more when you have a ball, you're compressing your own chest. So you're getting half breaths. So you're having to focus and control on the half breaths until you get back to the full breaths. And then you're back in that oxygen depth, but you're trying to recover that oxygen depth while you're on the bike. As he says, pace. And then the more you try to just use your arms instead of holding it at your chest, the more you fatigue your complete biceps out. And then you get back in the bike and you're fucked, so as you say, understanding of pace is very important.
I mean, the biggest thing for that is tension.
Yeah.
Like I said, breathing under tension. Yeah. When you have that ball, you're squeezing that ball on your chest, you know, trying to simulate even like a grappling situation. But like you're squeezing that thing, you feel it, and you're dying for a breath. You gotta come right out of that, and you gotta be able to control that breath and not, because that's where people go nuts.
Yeah.
That's one thing people like literally never, at least in my experience, I haven't seen or talked about, is that transition from squeezing somebody as hard as you can to coming out and being like under control to be able to throw strikes and just move again in general. Because
yeah.
Most of the time they're just out and it's hands down.
Back under their arms again.
Yeah.
So that's fucking such good specific training. Sweat like a cunt.
You sure?
As I said, they fucking, you get the messages from home, it's a very Irish thing to say, you've got some time, but that's what people always say when you're out living your life, you're out traveling, you're out fucking grinding. They say, oh, you've some time, but it's like, they don't say that in a good way. A lot of people, they say, figure, all right, you're going out living all this good life, huh? What are you doing that for? You should be at home fucking miserable with me. Let me just drag you down here and say, it's all right for some people. Sorry for fucking me, because I fucking work hard.
Yeah.
Work harder than anyone. And that's why I fucking create this life. It fucking just gets me anytime I'm out and about, I'm doing good shit. It's like, oh, you've some time, but oh, here, you're living the dream, which some people say that, and they're like, in a positive way. Some people say, it's almost people say it with like a...
Yeah, like a sarcasm.
With like a bit of sarcasm and a little bit of resentment almost. I'm just thinking about that all day, and I was thinking about that when I was doing this. I'm like, fuck these people, they have no idea. If it was easy, everyone would be doing this shit. If it'd be easy, everyone would be in fucking UFC. Fucking superstar. So fuck what they say. Fuck what they say. Pandora. Pandora.
when Dana gives him that first UFC contract, it's like $10. Paul's gonna say $12.
$60.
$60,000.
You need to clip that so far.
$55. Hey, stop wasting my time of $55. No way I'd take my plane to Canada for less than $1,000.
Okay, $60.
$62.
What is that?
It still wouldn't fit my head. It still wouldn't fit my head. Wouldn't fit Paddy McCrory's head. Nice way to end the day. No better way to end the day at all. Get in the ocean. No one beats it. Start the recovery process. Feel nature. It's good shit. It's good shit. End of the day, end of the vlog, I guess. Hope you liked it. South Florida vlog, Daily P episode 3. God knows where God knows where episode 4 will be. God knows. Yeah. Rory would like it to be in Honolulu. Not right?
Sir.
Yeah. Episode 4 done. South Florida vlog. Let's go.
Boom! Oh.